sin. Pardon me, are you Aaron Burr, sir?
Asking.
Oh, well, sure. Sir, I'm Alexander Hamilton. I'm at your service, sir. I have been looking for you.
I'm getting nervous.
Sir, I heard your name at Princeton. I was seeking an accelerated course of study. When I got sort of out of sorts with a buddy of yours, I may have punched him. It's a blur. Sir, he handles the financials.
You punched the bursar.
Yes, I wanted to do what you did, graduate into and then join the revolution. He looked at me like I was stupid. I'm not stupid. So how'd you do it? How'd you graduate so fast?
Was my parents' dying wish before they passed.
You're an orphan, of course. I'm an orphan. God, I wish there was a war that we could prove that we're worth more than anyone bargained for.
Can I buy you a drink?
That would be nice.
While we're talking, let me offer you some free advice.
Talk less.
What?
Smile more. Don't let them know what you're against or what you're for.
You can't be serious.
You wanna get ahead?
Yes.
Fools who run their mouths off wind up dead.
Yo, what time is it?
Showtime!
Like I said.
Showtime. I'm John Lawrence in a place to be. A 2 pints of Sam Adams, but I'm working on 3. Those red coats don't want it with me, cause I will back, take a back, these guys till I'm free.
Oui, mon ami, je m'appelle Lafayette. The Lancelot of the revolutionary set. I came from afar just to say bonsoir to the king. Casse toi, who's the best? C'est moi.
Brah, I am Hercules Mulligan, up in it, loving it. Yes, I heard your mother say, come again. Lock up your daughters and horses. Of course, it's hard to have intercourse over corsets of corsets. No more sex, pour me another brew, son. Now raise a couple more to the revolution. Well, if it ain't the prodigy of Princeton College. Aaron Burr, give us a verse, drop some knowledge.
Good luck with that, you taking a stand.
You spit, I'll sit, we'll see where we land. Well, the revolution's imminent, what do you stall for?
If you stand for nothing, Burr, what do you fall for?
Who are you?
Who is this kid? What's he gonna do?
Trouble in the air, you can smell it. And Alexander's by himself, I'll let him tell.
I hadn't slept in a week, I was weak, I was awake. You've never seen a bastard orphan more in need of a break. Longing for Angelica, missing my wife. That's when Miss Mariah Reynolds walked into my life. She said,
I know you are there. So sorry to bother you at home, but I don't know where to go, and I came here all alone.
She said,
my husband's doing me wrong, beating me, cheating me, mistreating me. Suddenly he's up and gone. I don't have the means to go on.
So I offered her a loan, I offered to walk her home. She said,
you're too kind, sir.
I gave her $30 that I had socked away. She lives a block away. She said,
this one's mine, sir.
Then I said, Sam, we'll head back home. She turned red. She led me to a bed. Let her legs spread and said,
hey.
That's when I began to pray, Lord, show me how to say no to this. I don't know how to say no to this. Oh my God, she looks so helpless. And her body is screaming, hell yes. I received a letter from a Mr. James Reynolds, even better. It said,
dear sir, I hope this letter finds you in good health and in prosperous enough position to put wealth in pockets of people like me down on their luck. You see, that was my wife you decided to. You made the wrong sign. So time to take the piper and the pantry and buckle. And hey, you can keep seeing my whole life. The price is right, and I'm not telling you why.
I hit the letter and I raced to a place. Springtime put you in her face. She said,
oh, sir.
Half dressed, apologetic, a mess.
deep. It feels easier to just swim down. The Hamiltunes move uptown and learn to live with the unimaginable.
I spend hours in the garden. I walk alone to the store, and it's quiet uptown. I never liked the quiet before. I take the children to church on Sunday, a sign of the cross at the door, and I pray. That never used to happen before.
If you see him in the street, walking by himself, talking by himself, have pity.
Philip, you would like it uptown, it's quiet uptown.
He is working through the unimaginable. His hair is gone gray, he passes every day. They say he walks the length of the city.
You knock me out, I fall apart.
Can you imagine?
Look at where we are. Look at where we started. I know I don't deserve you, Eliza, but hear me out, that would be enough. If I could spare his life, if I could trade his life for mine, he'd be standing here right now, and you would smile, and that would be enough. I don't pretend to know the challenges we're facing. You need time, but I'm not afraid. I know who I marry. Just let me stay here by your side. That would be enough.
If you see him in the street, walking by your side, talking by your side, have pity.
Eliza, do you like it uptown? It's
dark, taking in the sights of the city. They are trying to do the unimaginable. Moments that the words don't reach, there's a grace too powerful to name. We push away what we can never understand. We push away the unimaginable. They are standing in the garden, Alexander by Eliza's side. She takes his hand. It's quiet uptown. Forgiveness. Can you imagine? Forgiveness. Can you imagine? If you see him in the street, walking by your side, talking by your side.